It's the end of the day with Ray. Hello, my friends. Okay, if you're watching this on YouTube, please hit the subscribe button now that I got that out of the way. Someone told me I should tell people to do that. I never have, so I did. Ladies and gentlemen, today is Rico Part 2. Earlier this week, I did a video on Rico. You know the great announcement. It doesn't matter how you heard the announcement. I use the word paperless. People use the word Rico doesn't see print as important to him anymore and all these crazy things. And now we're seeing over the last week, Rico going back on the comment. Oh, no, we didn't mean it that way. Oh, it's not that bad. No, print's very important to us. Folks, here's what Rico said that's 100% true, and there's no way to spin it. They even have a pie chart on their website in a presentation that proves it. Here's what they said. Let me pull up the pie chart in case you forgot. They said this, ladies and gentlemen, our sales of office printing are going to go from 41% to 35% by the year 2025. That's a 6% decline. Not an increase, it's a decline. They said the operating profit from office printing is going to go from 41% to 25%. That's a 16% decline. That's what they said. That's what they showed you with their PowerPoint, right? There's no reason to walk it back. There's no reason to say, oh, dealers, we didn't mean to get you upset. Let's talk about our new machines that are coming out next week. Nobody cares. Let me ask every OEM a question. Every one of you, do we really need another MFP coming out? What are we going to do different? I mean, what's the old joke? Does it make coffee? I mean, are we coming out with one that actually makes coffee? My God, you press green for go, red for stop. Nobody even reduces and enlarges anymore. Nobody cares about automatic tray switching anymore. Most of that stuff nobody even uses anymore. You know, nobody's scanning like they did in 1990. So in all reality, can't we just have a couple of different models? Wouldn't that make more sense? Get rid of all that manufacturing, just make a few models. And that way you could lower the price to the dealers. And they could go out into the marketplace and sell that to those customers. Maybe at the same price, making them a little bit more operating profit. Well, could you imagine that? I mean, first of all, why would Rico admit that their operating profit on office printing is going to decrease by 16%? That seems kind of crazy to me. It seems like if I was a stockholder, I'd say, well, why is that? That's your core deliverable. Why is it going to shrink 16%? If you're only going to lose 6% in sales, why is your operating profit going to decrease by 16%? And then they can start having a conversation. Well, you know, if we made less machines, we could probably get more operating profit. You know, that would work. What if we didn't come out with a machine every 6 months? I mean, folks, there's a lot of things that got to change in the space. But here's the reality. It doesn't matter what the aspirations of an OEM or a dealer is to how many MFPs they're going to sell in the marketplace. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what they claim on a pie chart. It doesn't matter what they claim in a performer. You know who decides how many MFPs are going to go into the marketplace? The people that use them. The end user. That's who decides. And over this pandemic, they've decided what? I don't print as much as I used to. Do I really need this big giant boat anchor by the water fountain? They got an awareness like never before. People like DocuSign, explosive, off-the-charts growth. Every single one of those signatures that's done electronically for the first time to an end user, guess what? Used to be printed off and scanned back in. Millions and millions and millions of them aren't going to do that anymore. They just announced today or yesterday that they've integrated with Google. Whew. Think of how many pages aren't going to be printed, signed, wrote on, and scanned back in. Ladies and gentlemen, the market is shifting drastically, and it's not drifting. It's not shifting or changing or declining because the OEM decided it's going to decline or the dealer said, I'm going to stop selling print as much. I'm going to tell all my customers. I'm going to call them up tomorrow and say, don't print as much. You see, the customers, they just do what they do. And they base what they do on their needs. Not on an OEM's manufacturing facility. Not on a dealer's aspirations to continue selling big giant A3s forever and booklet finishers. They decide what they're going to use in their business for their benefits. Not for the benefits of an industry that can't get out of its own way sometimes. So I just want to talk a little bit about this finish up my video from last week because I think it's kind of funny that Rico's going around now trying to justify what they meant or what they said. And like I said a little bit ago, it doesn't matter what new machines are coming out with. None of that matters. What matters is what are these other services going to be in your dealership? And can you get them from Rico? Can you get them from Xerox? What are these other services going to be? And who can you get them from? And how are you going to make money when you deliver them to your customer? That's the reality, my friends. That's the reality. Have a great weekend. I'm going to end this the way I always do. Status quo is the killer of all that will be invented. Don't get stuck in status quo, and I'll see y'all on Monday.